All right. Hey, everyone. Good afternoon. Thanks for joining us. I have Corey with me again.
Hi. So nice to see everybody.
Thanks for joining us on this live stream. I really do appreciate it. Also, by the way, if you are joining us live right now, make sure to leave a comment or question, feedback, anything like that down below in the comment section. Corey's watching everything closely, and she'll be addressing those, as well as we'll be doing some shout-outs here in the live stream in just a minute or so. Corey will be doing some shout-outs. So in this live stream, I do want to talk about three different bills that are out there right now that would result in increases to Social Security checks, as you probably noticed with the title on this. And yes, this would also encompass millions upon millions of beneficiaries, those people that do receive benefits from the Social Security Administration. There's a lot of people, like you've heard me say before, well over 71 million people that get checks as of right now every single month from Social Security. So, do you want to start with some shoutouts?
You know what? I'm having
technical difficulties.
Yeah, I'm having a tough. I think everybody's maybe was having a little bit of a technical difficulty, but it looks like we're good now.
Is it fixed?
Yes, I can.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, I can actually do shoutouts. Okay.
Okay.
So we've got James Roberts, Becky Schreider, Barbara Haskell, Veronica K, Amara Sawyer, Matthew Pace, Shell Brown, Anita Rutland, Dominic McLaughlin, Robert Hammond, Jimmy Johnson, Sherilyn Shanahan, and thank you for being a member, but I'm sorry that your last name
thank
is
you.
Totally, I'm struggling. Leah Ketchum, Ruby Robinson, Jane Drews, Dean Lalonde, Sandy Goodbar, Patricia, Robin Brockett, Sherry Congdon, Mike Aldridge, Brian Burton, Karen Greger, Felipe Rosario, Quinn 30, Kimberly Long, David Stone, Myra Maines, and Matthew McIntyre.
Wow, nice.
You guys, I just feel like when I read names, I should like, it's like one of those things where it's like a tongue twister.
Yeah.
Like I get like nervous because I'm so bad at pronouncing names. So I'm doing my best.
Yeah. Well, you did a good job.
Thank you.
No, seriously. Dude, she does a lot better than I do. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's great. By the way, she'll do shout outs here again in just a few minutes, but we'll talk about a few things here, and then we can do more shout outs in a little while. So make sure to keep those comments or the chat coming in if you want to. You don't need to. Your option. All right. So anyway, I do want to talk about some things because I continue to get a lot of questions about this. This is something that's going on for a very long time and something that I just want to talk about here with you live in this stream, because why not talk about it right here? And again, you can throw your questions and comments and stuff like that down below and we'll do our best to answer those for you. But as you all know, if you've been watching the videos on the channel for a while now, you know that there's a lot of piece of legislation out there to change Social Security. And we all know that this is going to be reformed at some point, probably sooner than later, right? You've heard me talk about that. Even though a lot of us probably think, nah, they're not going to do anything, they will. They don't know what they're going to do yet. I've been saying for a long time now, 2024 is going to be all about Social Security, and I would bet they're going to bring up a lot of different things. In fact, we just saw the debate that happened, what was that, a week and a half ago? Maybe 2 weeks ago now, the debate that happened, and all those people coming out talking about what they want to do with Social Security. But again, this video is not about that. I'm just saying there's a lot of people that are talking about it. But my point is, this is a very important thing, and we know that the next administration must do something about this. So as a result of that, I want to focus on three key pieces of legislation that are out there, because these are pretty good ones. Now, I've talked about lots of bills and packages over the last, you know, almost four years now. We've been talking about this. Well, obviously, if something was introduced, say, 4 years ago, it's probably no good anymore, right? They're probably not paying a lot of attention to it. But I want to talk about these because these are, in my honest opinion, probably the best ones that are out there that would actually impact benefits the most and probably have the highest probability of actually passing. So, quick questions or should I keep going?
I'll do a couple shout-outs. Is
okay.
that okay?
Yeah, sure.
Linda Burns, great. Joe Congilio, Hawaii 5-0, Joshua Osborne, Gary Carr, Rita Padilla, Ronald Bigger, Jacqueline Banks, Nodak Wolf Diecast, Chris Langinette, Cecilia Aguinaldo, Linda Lopez, Lisa Erickson, Denise M., Levi Freedom, Ida Cooper, Rondell, Shirley Kirby, Leroy.
Nice.
There you go.
A lot of good names. I like a lot of names. I mean, seriously.
I know. There's a lot of...
When I hear the names called, so I think, oh, that's a catchy name. I like that. Yeah.
I know. It is interesting. And yeah. People have not had questions necessarily so far, but just...
Perfect.
Hello, hello.
Nice. Thanks, everyone.
Hello,
nice
hello,
to see you.
Tony
yeah,
Velo.
I hope you're doing well on Thanksgiving week, right? Couple days here. So, yeah, pretty exciting. It's crazy, right? We're the year ago already, right? Yeah. Oh, by the way, if you haven't done so, make sure to subscribe. There's a subscribe button down there somewhere. Make sure to hit that. A lot of things are going on right now, and we will keep you updated with everything going on every single day, doing all the research, watching everything closely. We want to help you out. We've got to stick together through this time as well. It's a busy time out there, and the more people we have here in the community, again, the more power and influence we have when we reach out to these lawmakers. Like that letter we sent out, what was that? A week, 2 weeks ago, probably now?
Yeah, maybe.
Sent out that letter? Yeah, about 2 weeks ago now. So that was a good one, by the way. I thought that was a pretty good one. Anyway, all right, so let's talk through these bills one at a time here. So some of this may sound a little bit repetitive, but let me talk you through the details. Now, one of the aspects of all three of these pieces of legislation is to change the way that the COLA is calculated. Now, before you jump off, let me tell you this much. This is not all about the COLA, okay? But I just wanted to talk about that really quickly because this is one of the commonalities between all of these pieces of legislation is change the COLA, right? Well, here's the thing. We know that the COLA never keeps up with real inflation, right? If you don't believe me, look at the COLA for 2024, 3.2%. Do you think that's going to account for anything that we've been dealing with for the last year? No, I don't think so, right? We all know that, right? So this is no surprise. We're all very aware that it never really keeps up. So this is what they want to do. And again, the change of the COLA from the CPIW to the CPIE would only be a little bit of a couple tenths of a percent per year, maybe like 1 to 2, maybe 3% on a very rare time over about a 10-year period of time. So it's not a huge increase, but as you've heard me talk about before, time and compounding translates into a lot of money, right? Compounding, right? Isn't that Einstein that said it's like the eighth wonder of the world or something? I don't know. I wasn't around when Einstein was here. But apparently Einstein said something like that. Apparently Einstein said that. Like compounding is like the eighth wonder of the world, or is it seven? I don't know.
Well, there's something seven like wonders of the world, okay, but maybe so it'd be it's eight. The eighth.
Yeah, but anyway, my point is compounding is very important when it comes down to money, time, things like that. So it adds up very quickly. All right, so anyway, let's talk through these one at a time here. So the Social Security Expansion Act, this is a big one. This is the one that I get questions on literally every single day. You see the questions, I know you do, in the comments section every day. People come in and ask about this piece of legislation. This is the one that that encompasses the infamous $200 per month raise, right? You've seen the questions.
Yeah.
You see the questions today? I know you have.
Yeah, I have.
Seriously.
I saw
questions earlier this morning about it.
I'm going to really quick say, yep. Matt is right. Albert Einstein said, compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world.
Nice. Sweet.
He said, he who understands it, earns it. He who doesn't, pays it.
Ah, that's a good one. Yeah, guess what? Banks, do they understand compound interest? Oh, they better do. They do, right?
Yeah.
Why do you think banks have so much money, right? Yeah, they get compound interest. So anyway, but yeah, that's interesting.
It's interesting that you knew that. Like, you're just a wealth of knowledge. Really? Like,
I don't know.
Crazy times. Yeah, so anyway, just thought I'd look that up.
I might have some knowledge, but I still struggle to talk sometimes.
That's okay.
If you haven't noticed yet, I'm sweating. My palms are all sweaty. I can't even talk today. By the way, the video that I posted earlier this morning, that took me a lot of takes. I don't know. Some days I'm like, kind of good. I sit here and I can just kind of get it done. Some days it takes me a long time. I sit here and go over and over and over, and it's like the words just don't come out. So that was one of those days today, and apparently it's still happening today, like right now. So yeah, it's kind of embarrassing. But anyway, so the Social Security Expansion Act, this is a big one. I get questions on this literally every day about the $200 per month raise, right? Now, again, we all know this, and I want to be fair with you right away here. This has not been passed through Congress yet, okay? But I have been seeing some things popping up about it, and I would not be shocked one bit if old Bernie and his buddies, Bernie Sanders, by the way, comes out and starts talking about this again in a lot more frequency than what we've been seeing here over the last year or so, okay? Like I said, 2024, I guarantee you Bernie will be talking about this. So we'll have to see what happens here. But again, this is going to be a very important one to watch because it comes down to this. Think of it this way. What do we have coming up in about a year? Well, it's not quite a year even, right? Early November 2024, the election, okay? So think of it this way. We're approaching the election and some people want to get their agenda done, right? Remember this. Lawmakers, what do they want to do? They want to get their agenda done because they want to get a little, you know, a little sticker on their shirt, a little gold star on their shirt that says, I did a good job, right? They want the gold star. So anyway, when they're approaching an election or a very pivotal time like that, they come out and they say, hey, we've got to get this done. And then if it passes for some weird reason, it actually does pass through Congress, then they say, look, my agenda, my plan, my idea changed the lives of millions of people, and it's good for the country, right? So it's a win. But then if it doesn't get done, what do? They point the fingers at the people that didn't vote for it or never even brought it to the floor and say, look, it's their fault that all these people are struggling because my plan would have changed their lives. You see how that works?
I do.
Yeah. So anyway.
It sounds like a lot of finger pointing.
Yeah, it can be. So my point is, again, I don't want to turn this into a political thing, but again, you got to read between the lines when it comes down to these political games, because they all do it every single time. And what's going on in about a year with the elections next year, it's going to be very, very important. So my point is, we all know that Social Security and fixed income beneficiaries and the low income, well over 40 million people, which, by the way, I have another video that I want to share with you, some information I just found this morning. Yeah, these numbers are getting very, very big right now. So stay tuned for that video. I'll have that out here within the next couple of days or so. But anyway, that's some pretty interesting stuff. So we know that low income fixed income beneficiaries are in the spotlight 100% for 2024 because they know this is the group of people that basically hold a huge percentage of the votes, right? The low income, fixed income, seniors, older adults, people like this, they know that they show up in huge numbers to vote, and they know that if they do the right things, they can capture a lot of votes pretty easily, okay? So as a result of this, this is going to be a hot button issue in 2024, even the Social Security Expansion Act. And remember, this is the one that does increase benefits, $200 per month, basically out until the end of the century. It's about 75 years. So I'm not sure about you, but I think 75 years would do me pretty good, right? I'm not sure if I'm going to be around 75 years. I don't think so.
I'd be trying to do the math.
I'd be pretty old.
You would be.
I don't even, what is the math in that? 115? 104? Yeah, something like that. Gosh, I don't know. Yeah. It's more than that. Yeah, no, it's about 115. Yeah, okay. I think I'm good at 115. I don't know. So anyway, that'd be awkward. Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
What?
No, it would.
Yeah. Okay. So anyway, yes, this is the one that would increase the benefits by that $200 out until the end of the century. So this would be a really good one. And there's also a bunch of other things within there as well, which would reform Social Security. But I'm going to be honest with you, it's not really that beneficial to the beneficiary. It's like raising taxes and stuff like that. Honestly, who cares about that stuff? You want to focus on the $200 that would go in for the beneficiaries. All right. So that's number one. Quick questions here?
A couple comments and questions I'm actually going to read.
Okay.
Gary Carr, who said he's been watching for a really long time. Your name
I know.
Is, yes.
Gary, I see awesome. Your name in the comment section all the time. So yeah, thanks, Gary. I appreciate it.
He thinks there should be different COLAs for different incomes on Social Security.
Totally. Totally nailed it, Gary. Yeah. Not only that, we said this in the live stream the other day too. Not only should there be a COLA based on different levels of benefit, right? So lower the benefit, higher the COLA, higher the benefit, lower the COLA, right? That's just kind of a basic stuff right there. But not only that, demographics as in your location. Are you located in New York or New Jersey or Illinois or what's another expensive spot? California? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe these people that have a very high cost of living should maybe also be getting a higher COLA, right?
Well, kind of like make it match the cost of living that's changing in your area. So
yeah.
Like maybe make cost of living adjustment actually be a cost of living, mm-hmm. I don't know, adjustment?
Yeah. And that's the thing too. They've also talked about completely eliminating the COLA for higher income people. So that's another interesting proposal out there as well. I talked about that, I don't know, over the summer sometime, I think, maybe 3-4 months ago, something like that, I talked about that. But there's also a proposal, to do exactly that. Basically, take the COLA and just wipe it out from anybody that gets a benefit over about $2,200 a month. They basically say, hey, sorry, no more COLA. And they basically just give that money to the lower income people. So, I don't know, kind of an interesting concept.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, other questions or concerns?
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly. I'm going to throw a curveball at you, Matt.
Oh.
You love curveballs.
Yep. Sure do. Pull out the cork bat.
Yep. Yeah, on a live stream. No going back now.
I don't know anything about baseball, but I think corked bats are not, they're not legal in the game because you can hit home runs really easily, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Anyway,
I don't know.
I don't know anything about baseball.
I know. Matt always makes sports analogies, and I'm like, dude, like, you don't even know sports stuff.
That's very true. I don't.
Three dogs and a paw want to know, I am blind and 62 years old. Will I get a review? Do you know what that means?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's totally, that's really interesting. I don't really know how to answer that other than saying it's really hard to say, right? So in this situation, honestly, I don't really know your exact situation, so I can't say like yes for sure. I wouldn't be surprised if you get a review. It kind of depends on your situation. You said you're 62 and you're blind. So I guess what I'm curious too is, depending on what caused your blindness, so if it's like a permanent condition, they would likely give you a review in a very long time. So typically that happens like 7 years or after. But if your blindness is something that they potentially look at as something like, you could maybe get cured someday, or maybe it has fixed itself, then maybe they would say, well, it's time to get a review, right? So that's a very personalized type of question. Honestly, I don't really know, but I would say this much. Don't be surprised if you do get a review at some point, because if you receive SSDI benefits long enough, you probably will get a review at some point, okay? So yeah, that's kind of a personalized thing.
Okay.
But yeah, don't be surprised if you get a review. In fact, I would say this much as well. If you're an SSDI beneficiary, you're probably going to get a review at some point, okay? Just kind of be prepared for it. There's likely going to be a review at some point, regardless of how long you've been receiving SSDI.
Okay. Thank you. Gil Velasquez says having a cork bat is a no-no.
Yeah, right.
So that's good to know.
Because cork is like, it's like springy, right? So you hit the ball and it's like a little, it's like spring-loaded bat, boing, right over the stadium.
There you go. Yeah. Lynn Coles wants to know, Matt, what is your favorite kind of pie for Thanksgiving?
Oh, man. good question. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not really like a pie or cake person. Corey's always trying to like force cake on me, and I'm like, I don't like cake. I just don't. I just
me
not
and
a
the
fan.
Kid both are.
Yeah. As far as pie, though, honestly, pecan. I really like pecan pie. I don't really eat pie, but I'm saying if I had my choice of pecan, apple, pumpkin, what are the other ones?
I don't know.
Yeah, I know a guy that likes raisin pie. Have you ever heard of such a thing?
You know what? Maybe
raisin pie.
You guys do.
Kurt.
No, I know. It's Kurt.
Likes, she knows him.
I know.
He likes raisin pie. My mom made him a raisin pie one time, and my dad was like, Kurt, are you going to eat that? He's like, yeah, I love it. And he sat there and ate the pie. My mom's like, this is nuts. I don't know. Weird.
But we don't judge.
Yeah, no.
I don't care what you guys like for pie. So, like, by all means, like, shout it out if you like the raisin pie.
I'm just curious. I never heard of such a thing until this guy was like, I love raisin pie. Like, I never knew that was even a thing.
Mm-hmm. Not a big fan of raisins.
Yeah.
Just throwing out there. Okay.
Yeah. All right. So let's keep rolling here unless you have something you can stop.
Nothing to do with anything but pie at this point.
Okay. I'm going to ramble here for another minute or two, and then we'll have Corey do some more shout outs. So keep those comments coming in so she can give you a shout out here.
Yeah.
All right. So number two, really quickly here, let's talk about SSI Restoration Act. Now, this is another one that has been coming up a lot. In fact, we've been seeing questions about a provision within this one in the live streams here quite a bit over the last several weeks here, which is the removal of the marriage penalty. Now, more on that here in just a second, but the SSI Restoration Act is one that's been out there for a few years now, and this is actually a really, really good piece of legislation. It's been around for a while now, and honestly, if they're gonna do any reform to SSI, which they really, really need to, this would be the one to do. This encompasses basically all of the different changes for SSI that they really need to do. Now, again, remember, SSI has been around since 1972. The last time it was reformed was in 1989. It's about time to reform it, right? Well, here's the thing. Let me buzz through really quickly some of the key things, some of the key provisions within the SSI Restoration Act that would really change this program in a good, good way. Number one, remove the marriage penalty for SSI beneficiaries. So if they remove the marriage penalty, that would boost benefits significantly for married people or those people that want to become married. Now, all of a sudden, their benefits are not being garnished like they are right now, right? So that's number one. Next, raising benefits up to the federal poverty line. Right now, the federal poverty line is $14,580 a year, or what is it? Now I'm forgetting what the number is. $1,215. I think that's what the math is on that. On a monthly basis, sorry, I have a lot of numbers in my head. $1,215 on a monthly basis is what that is. And remember, they want to raise that up. So if they did this, this would increase benefits for SSI beneficiaries up to the federal poverty line. And guess what? Every year that the federal poverty line increases, SSI benefits, if this is put in place, would adjust to the federal poverty line. Not bad, right? Pretty cool. So it's not a ton, but it would also be adjusting. And again, these beneficiaries would not be well below what the federal poverty line is as of right now. So it's about $300 a month is where beneficiaries are currently below the federal poverty line. So That's a good one as well. Next, another provision within this one is also to increase asset levels or possession limits of cash and cash equivalents. As you know, as an SSI beneficiary, you can have $2,000 as an individual or $3,000 as a married couple. If you have over that limit, well, you might want to kiss your benefits goodbye because they're pretty much ending at that point, right? They can kick you out of the program. Get that. They can kick you out of the program if you have more than $2,000 as an individual or $3,000 as a married couple. Is that crazy or what?
That's ridiculous.
Kick people out of the program. Seriously. End benefits because you have $2,000. I'm sorry, but if anything breaks these days, like an air conditioning unit, a car engine, a transmission, a furnace, seriously, all of that is $2,000 plus, way more than that, right? $2,000 these days is not going to get you much anymore. So, yeah, it's a weird thing.
It is.
Shoutouts?
A lot of pie talk.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nice.
You know what? Oh, Frank, Matt, I think we know what kind of pie is your favorite. Frank Cassatari wrote his favorite pie is money pie.
Money pie.
That nice. Would be Matt's favorite pie.
Nice. That's a good one, Frank.
It's
I like
good.
It. So, coins or paper?
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just a lot of pie, a lot of pie stuff.
Anybody respond about the raisin pie?
No raisin pies yet.
Okay.
But I did want to share so somebody said their favorite kind of pie is key lime pie.
Oh,
so
my.
So I have to share a fun little story about Matt.
Okay.
Do you know the story?
Yeah.
Yeah, Matt knows the story. So the first time he came to visit my parents, so I lived with my parents when we started dating. Matt lived with his parents, actually, and we started dating. But anyway, he made me a key lime pie for, like, it was one of our first dates, really, the day he came to visit my family. So he brought a key lime pie that he had baked that morning to my parents' house, and it won all of us over. I was, like, just smitten. Guess how many, okay, I'm just going to say, though, how many key lime pies have you made me since then? Like, roughly.
Zero.
The answer is zero. Now that I think about it, I'm like, it was so sweet you won me over. And then I'm like, literally none more have been made in like 9 years.
Yeah.
His mom makes me pie.
I'll share a little secret. The key lime pie that she's talking about that I got all the credit for, my mom made it. I didn't do it. I just stood there and supervised the whole time. So thanks, Mom. My mom did it.
But you know what?
My mom's looking it up online. She's like, how do you make this thing? She's looking up the recipe. And I'm like, I don't know. Just tell me what to do. And I'll just stand here and supervise. So I did. And she made it.
But you know what? It was awesome. Like the sweetest thing. It was really, really sweet.
It was my idea. And my mom was like, I'll help you. And she just did all of it. So
yeah,
it was good. I was present.
We were not young when this happened to you.
No, this was just like not that many years ago.
We were like 29. So it wasn't like he was like 17.
No.
Didn't know how to make a pie.
Yeah, this was not that many years ago.
Anyway.
29, 30, something like that.
Yeah.
Right.
So there we go.
Funny. Do you want to do shout-outs or should I talk about the next one?
Ooh, cream cheese pie. That sounds good. Yep,
oh,
I'm going to do some shout-outs. Kamala Sherry, Jennifer Morrow, Gary Carr, Veronica Kay, Megan Murphy, Dana Wilmoth, Gil Velasquez, Lynn Coles, Debbie Kozlowski, Deanne Smock, Gabby Rodriguez, Linda Preventure, James Roberts. You've been here this whole time. Actually, here's a question. What's the difference between SSI and SSA?
SSI and SSA. So
yes.
SSA is just kind of an acronym to represent Social Security Administration. So a lot of times when people say SSA, they're referring to retirement benefits. As far as SSI, Supplemental Security Income, that's technically not Social Security, but it's administered by the Social Security Administration, and that's a totally different program. So, yeah, SSA, retirement benefits, that's generally what it's referring to a lot of times, but really it stands for Social Security Administration and then Supplemental Security Income, SSI. Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. Crystal Coachman, Lloyd Wynn, John Beckham, Teresa Privet, Denise M., Yellow Jacket, Hawaii 50, Walter, Libby, Ruby Robinson, Dana Wilmoth, Audie Hust, Philip Sharp, Connie Pruitt, John Beckham, Miss Marie, Anthony Thornton, Vicky Gillespie, Barbara Haskell, Frank Cassatari. Oh, we talked about your money pie. There we go.
Nice.
Yeah.
You know what? I noticed a lot of names have been here the whole time.
Yeah, very that's cool. Super cool.
Yeah, thank you. That's great.
Salvador Bonifiglio.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very cool. Great. Thank you. Thanks for being here. All right. So let's talk about the next one. Gather some more names so we can do more shout outs here in a minute. All right. So the next one. So we talked about the Social Security Expansion Act. That one was the number one. That's the one that contains the $200 raise. The SSI Restoration Act, again, specifically focused on SSI. A great piece of legislation there. That is a really good one. It's been around for a while now. Why they haven't passed it yet? That's a good question. Not really sure. Maybe 2024 will bring something like that. And hopefully it does, because that would be great. Well, honestly, hopefully it happens before then, but I'm going to be real with you. It probably won't, because there's only like a month left, right? Between now and when they leave for their holiday break, stuff like that. So next, I quickly want to talk about the Social Security 2100. Now, this is also one that's been around for a while, but about a year, what was it? Maybe a year and a half or so ago, it went through and it got a second iteration, okay? So this is another one that's out there that's pretty important, and there's about a dozen different provisions within it that actually help out SSI, reforms the program, raises benefits, all kinds of different things like that. So the new, I guess, technical name of this one, it started out as the Social Security 2100, and now it is the Social Security 2100, Social Security 2100, a sacred trust. So that's what it is now. That's what it's called. But it's like the second iteration of the bill. But anyway, this one has about a dozen provisions with it. Again, it adjusts the COLA. It raises the minimum guaranteed benefit for beneficiaries up to 125% of the federal poverty line. That'd be pretty nice right there. It also establishes another 5% increase for lower income beneficiaries that have been receiving benefits for quite a while, quite a few years. There's other provisions in there as well, but those are some of the big ones. And this is another a good piece of legislation, but the major problem with this one is that these provisions sunset after 5 years. So in other words, what I mean by that is they come in, they change up Social Security for 5 years, and then they kind of disappear. So even though this sounds like a good plan, it's like, well, why would we want it to go back and revert to normal after 5 years? Would that really solve the issue? Probably not really, right? So even though this is a good one, in my honest opinion, I don't really know if this one would pass in its current state. I could see some of the provisions within it maybe being pulled out, like cherry picked out of it, and say, hey, these look pretty good, but why would we want to sunset all of this in just 5 years, right? So it does look pretty good. There's some different things about it that look interesting, and it does look reliable. And John Larson in the House of Representatives has been talking about this one for several years now, even the new iteration. So we'll have to see what happens here with that one, but want to bring these three to your attention right now, because these are looking pretty good, especially the first two that I shared with you. Those ones are pretty good. So anyway, yeah.
Yeah.
Questions, concerns, or shout-outs?
Mostly like shout-outs, I would say. And then maybe we should wrap it up.
Okay.
Salvador Bonifilio for Ferido Lucerna, who's from Puerto Rico.
Wow. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Robin Richardson, Vicky Gillespie, Crystal Coachman, Veronica K, Dutch, who likes mincemeat pie.
Oh, my. Nice.
Yeah. Shell Brown, Jennifer Morrow, Dana Wilmoth, Shauna 01, Carl Hitchcock, Chris Lignetti, who likes pizza pie. I do too.
Pizza pie?
You know, pizza.
Yeah?
It's a pizza pie.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I get it. Right over my head
it's
for
a
second
pizza
there.
Pie.
Yeah, yeah, I get it. I get it now. I get it now.
Catherine Sonbera, Joe Guerra, Mo 3. He says LOL about the pizza pie.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah. So
funny.
Yeah, there we go. Vivian McKeithen. McKeithen.
Nice. Yeah. Thanks, everyone.
Yeah.
You're funny. Seriously, there's a lot of funny people here.
I know. I'm really enjoying this, like, so much.
Yeah, thank you. Anything else?
I don't think any more questions. Okay. People are LOLing, though, Matt.
Yeah, that's good.
Matt doesn't eat pizza. So.
Depends. Yeah, sometimes they do, but rarely.
Oh, Gladys Alvario is from Dominican Republic.
Oh, wow. Really? Very cool.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We've been there a couple times.
We have.
It's nice.
We went there
on
our honeymoon.
We did. Yeah, 12 days.
Punta Cana.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was nice. That was a long time ago.
Super nice, yeah.
It was actually kind of funny.
There was all these, it like rain every so often, right? So we'd see the storm clouds coming in like over the water and we're like, all right, take cover. And we'd like hide under our towels and stuff. And like 3 minutes later, we'd come out and be like, all right, it's sunny again for like 3 minutes. It was kind of fun.
It was really fun.
I guess you had to be there.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it was really fun though.
Yeah, no, that was a fun time.
Oh, gal, we've got another person from far away. This is super cool. 670M's vlog here all the way from Guam.
Whoa, nice.
Yeah.
That's like out in the middle of the Pacific, I think, somewhere. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not really sure exactly where it is. I know it's like a tiny island out like very far away.
It's a territory.
But it's a U.S. territory. I know that.
Yep.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I know that Guam. Because I'm Googling it.
Yeah.
That's great.
Very cool. Yeah, thanks for being here. This is cool. All right, so we wrap this up probably?
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we hope you have a really nice Thanksgiving, which, by the way, don't worry. I'll be back tomorrow and on Thanksgiving every day, which, by the way, I have not missed a single day being here for all of you in the last 4 years. Almost 4 years. Not quite 4 years. The channel's been around for, almost 6 years? The channel has been, but it was very sporadic for the first, I don't know, 2 years at least. 2.5 years probably, but I've been here literally every single day for almost 4 years now, even on holidays. So, yeah, I'll still be here on Thanksgiving. Again, why? Because we should be spending time with family, right? Well, guess what? We're all kind of like one big family here as well, right? So we've got to stick together right now, and I'm going to be here for you. I promised you guys that for years now, and I will continue to do that for you every single day, no matter what. That's my promise, and I'm sticking to it, unless Corey says... You can't. And then I'm going to say, you know what? That's my promise. I have to stick to it.
I don't say you can't.
No.
It'll give us time.
So if
to
I don't
ready.
Show up, it's because of Corey.
Oh.
I'm kidding. It's not. She's nice. She lets me do what I want. With the videos, I mean. Gosh.
No, I do.
Yeah.
Yeah. There
All
we
right.
go.
Okay. Anything else?
No, I think we're good. People All are right. just happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Make sure to do the coloring contest.
And
LOLing. Okay, good. Make sure to do the coloring contest of the turkey in your local paper on Thursday. Mm-hmm. Right? Do they still do that? I'm pretty sure they do.
I don't know.
I feel like that's something that they do all across the whole country. Like send out the little turkey and you're supposed to color it and maybe you can win like a t-shirt or something. I don't know. Yeah.
That'd be a good way to get a t-shirt though.
I don't know if it's a t-shirt. I was just saying it's some kind of prize. I don't even know if it's a t-shirt.
I know you shouldn't say because like who knows?
I was just guessing. A t-shirt's like a pretty, you know, easy thing to give away.
Yeah.
I don't know. Cool. All right, everybody. Thanks so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. Again, subscribe if you haven't done so yet. Otherwise, stay tuned. We'll be back for you. Enjoy your day. If I don't see you until Thursday or something like that, again, have a nice Thanksgiving. Stay safe out there. Hope you can grab some deals. Again, quick side note, by the way, a couple days ago, what is today? What's today? Tuesday?
The date?
Yeah.
Tuesday.
Today's Tuesday. So on Sunday, I made a video and I talked about $40 for free. If you haven't seen that, check it out. So the deal is it's an app I've been using for many years. And again, you can get back a ton of money when you use that thing all the time on your purchases online. You get a lot of money back. You saw it right there in that video. I've gotten back $3,629.75. I wasn't going to tell you that. I stashed all that money away. No, I'm just kidding. I did.
No, no,
she knows about it.
You can't stash money away from me.
She helps me get
I'm like
it.
Like a bloodhound.
Yeah. But my point is, when you sign up on that app, you also get $40. Once you make your first $40 purchase, you get $40 back. So it's literally like free, right? So anyway, check that video if you want to. If not, doesn't matter, whatever. I'm just trying to help you save some money right now, especially right now with the holidays and money being tight right now and stuff like that.
And you can shop at Walmart.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, it's like you could buy, like, your groceries.
We just saw Walmart 5% back.
Actually,
that.
It went up, too. It changes the percentage
every day.
So, it's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah,
and
take
you can use
of
it
that.
In, so you can use it in an app. It's an app, but you can use it in store or online.
Yeah.
But, like, Walmart's one that I saw that's like, just buy, like, bread or whatever.
Yeah.
And just use
Seriously.
It. No big deal.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
It's a nice way to save some money, especially right now. When things are tight for a lot of people. Mm-hmm. So anyway, check out the video if you want. If not, totally cool. Either way, we're here for you as much as we can be. We want to help you get money, save money, and just maximize checks, maximize monthly income, lifetime income, stuff like that. Whatever. We want to do whatever we can for you here in the community. So
and just make you happy, maybe.
Yeah, we're here for you. All right. Enjoy your day. Thanks everyone.
Bye-bye.
Enjoy. See you later.
Oh, we're not off yet. And because I accidentally forgot to push the button, but somebody wants to know what the app is called. Oh. Did you say what it is?
I did not say.
Oh, that's important.
Yeah. Check out the video from Sunday. There's a video just a couple days ago. It says like free $40. Otherwise, the name of the app is Rakuten, R-A-K-U-T-E-N, Rakuten.
I just put it in the comments too.
Weird. Yeah, weird name. I know.
Sorry.
R-A-K-U-T-E-N.
Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise, check out the video. If you use that link, you get that $40 for free. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Bye-bye.